Hi, my name is Chinmayi, best-selling author of Body Magic, and today I want to bring you a very special recipe, a very flexible recipe. A little bit of a history behind this one. This is called a crumble, and if you live across the pond, you might not know what a crumble is. But a crumble is a pudding or a dessert, and as I grew up, I used to love hot, steamy puddings with custard on. And then those days were made with white flour and margarine and lots of white sugar for the topping. I'm going to do it in a healthy way as a healthy alternative and also make it gluten and dairy free for you as well. And that's my philosophy really, is to bring you very simple recipes. I don't expect you to have to go way out very much in any of my recipes. This is really just throw it into a bowl and see how good it tastes. So the essence of a crumble is to have some kind of fruit on the bottom and something crumbly on the top, essentially. You can use fresh fruit. I'm going to make it really easy for myself today. I've got some apples here, which a friend gave us, a plethora of apples, and I didn't even soak them in syrup or anything like that. I just lightly cooked them, poured them into sterilized jars, and as they cooled down, they became vacuumed. And these are from September last year, and we're now in February, so they're absolutely fine. And if they're not fine, then you've really not lost very much at all. So I'm going to whip these out. As you can see, they're well sealed. Now I've got enough in here to make two crumbles because I'm going to add a couple of bits and bobs to them as well. So this isn't made with fresh fruit, it's made with jarred fruit. Just pour a little bit of that. This is natural syrup, so there's no sweetener in here at all. Coming out. And I'll just divide this between two bowls. And what I'll do is I'll probably freeze one of them. So I'm not planning on having retreats or visitors. So I've just split that up between the two. And as you can see, I didn't cook them very long, so the skins are still on and they still look like apples. It's not an apple mush. So onto this, I'm going to add a little bit of cinnamon. Some cinnamon in the jars with the apples in the first place, but I love cinnamon anyway, so it doesn't matter. And I'm also going to add in some soaked apricots and goji berries, just to give it a bit of colour and a little bit of a different flavour as well. Just bring those in there. This is so simple, so quick, and so delicious. Now the other magical thing about this recipe is that it doesn't just have to be for a dessert. As we come to lose our sweet cravings for something sweet after a meal, maybe don't want a dessert all that often, but it is nice on a Sunday after a Sunday lunch or something like that. You can also maybe just have a little bit of it and save the rest for the following morning or a couple of days later and have it as a breakfast, because it's absolutely full of goodness, full of iron and energy. And we do like to have some carbohydrates in the morning, some of us, to get us going. I certainly do. So in here for the crumble, I've got a mixture of, this is gluten free, I've got a mixture of rice flakes, buckwheat flakes and quinoa flakes. So these have all just been mixed up lightly together. So I'm just going to add into that a little bit of coconut. Instead of putting in sugar, I'm going to put in some stevia powder. And this isn't the processed stuff, this is the pure powder from the leaf. And you have to be really careful with this because it's really quite strong. So for both of these dishes, I really only need about, I would say, a third of a teaspoon, no more than that. Because it can have, it's supposed to be, I don't know, 20 to 30 times sweeter than sugar, but I think it's actually a lot sweeter than that. So So when you do get too much in, it has a really bitter taste. And I'm also going to throw on a little bit of lemon juice here as well. I love using these things because you get so much more lemon out of the lemon. But you could use orange or maybe lime if you wanted to as well. Helps to get some of the iron out of the apricots. If you want a more sweeter taste with the fruit, for example, when it's not stewed, it can be a little bit more bitter, so you could also put on maybe a bit of honey or some maple syrup as well, if you prefer. So I'm going to throw on the crumble now. And just to help the digestion, I'm going to put on some melted coconut oil. Also, fry off some of the crumble in some coconut oil beforehand if you want to do that. I'm all for keeping washing up down to a minimum. So also on top of this, I'm going to put on some ground up seeds. So I use, usually, nearly every day, pumpkin, linseed or flaxseed, and sunflower seeds. So I just put 50% of these and then 25% of the other two. Sometimes I'll throw in some chia seeds as well, and sesame depending on the dish. So these are all mixed up together, so I'm just going to sprinkle some of that on top as well. Gives it a nice colour as well. Okay. Now what you don't want to be eating is a pile of fruit with loads of dry flakes on top, because that's not very nice. So what I do is I just get some recently boiled water. I'm just going to dribble some water back and forth. You don't want to put too much in. We've got quite a bit of juice in the bottom of this already. But just to give it a little soak. There we go. Now they will expand a little bit as well. Good reason for using a glass bowl so you can see what you're doing. Hope you find this really easy to do. There's no set rules either. You can use oats only if you want to. You don't have to put cinnamon on. You can use fresh fruit. It's really very flexible. It's just an idea. For breakfast, because it would have dried out quite a bit by the morning, I can have it cold, sometimes with some rice milk on, which is quite sweet. Or you could warm it up and warm some milk up and put it over the top, some plant milk if you want to keep it vegan. But there's lots of ways and lots of permutations of this dish. So I'll put these into the oven now for about 20 to 30 minutes on around about 200 degrees centigrade, which is 400 Fahrenheit or gas mark 6. Just to really give it a little bit of dryness on the top, just to crisp it off a little bit and allow the oats to continue to soak up some of the fruit juice. Okay, so 30 minutes has passed. Healthy alternatives to custard or ice cream. In the meantime, I like to use a little bit of, this is rice milk, because it's actually quite sweet. It just gives it a little bit of moisture. That means you can eat it a little bit quicker because it's cold. Okay, thank you very much. I look forward to speaking to you again soon with some more delicious and simple recipes. In the meantime, if you'd leave a comment below this video, I'd be really grateful. Thank you very much. Namaste.